car seats. They can be confusing and difficult to work. So tonight, Dr. Lewis First, Chief of Pediatrics of the Vermont Children's Hospital at Fletcher Allen, tells us about them.
It's a well-known fact that infants don't go home from the hospital when they're born without a proper car seat or infant seat. And yet I'm amazed at how many families fail car seat safety inspections because their infant or child are not buckled in properly or the seat isn't fastened properly. So this week, let me drive home a few points about car safety seats. There are three types of car safety seats. There's your infant seat, toddler seat, and booster seat. The infant seat should be placed rearward facing because that reduces the risk of injury by more than 5 times in your little one. Your baby stays in that seat until they're over 20 pounds and over 1 year of age. If your child's over 20 pounds and not yet a year old, they should still stay facing to the rear in their infant seat. And some of these seats are now made to support weights of 35 to 40 pounds. And in fact, the American Academy of Pediatrics recommends you keep your child in a rearward-facing seat if it supports the weight until they're age 2. Now, if they're over 20 pounds and a year of age, they can graduate to a toddler seat. This faces frontward in the back seat and can support your toddler until they're 40 pounds. When they cross 40 pounds, they move to a booster seat. The booster seat is designed to support your child until they're over 4 feet 9 inches tall and more than 8 years of age. If your child is over 8 and still not 4 feet 9 inches, they should stay in the booster seat. What if your child doesn't want to get into the booster seat because they're 7 or 8 years of age? Well, don't call it a booster or baby seat. Point out the fact that your child will have a much better view of the road and they'll be much more comfortable when that lap and shoulder strap don't cross their face or hang across their belly, but sit low in their hips and across their shoulders. Not to mention, it's the law. Of course, once your child crosses 8 years of age and 4 feet 9 inches, they can get into the regular seat in the car, but they should still be in the back seat at least until age 12, because until then, kids aren't sized properly in case that front seat airbag deploys, and that could result in a serious head or neck injury. Parents, you need to set a good example too, so wear your seat belts at all times, so that hopefully tips like this will sit well with you and your children when it comes to making sure they're in the proper safety seat. This is pediatrician Dr. Lewis First from Vermont Children's Hospital of Fletcher Allen, reminding you to always be first with your kids.